Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about benchmarking multi-column versus multiple combined indexes in Postgres, and whether B-tree or hash indexes are a better fit. This is a blog post by Kaarel Moppel on his personal blog, where he's referencing another post that came up a couple of weeks ago. The original post by Simon talked about the difference between index merges versus composite indexes, and looked at both Postgres and MySQL. And the conclusion from Simon's post back then was the composite indexes perform much better than having multiple separate indexes. In Kaarel's post, he takes a very specific look at the Postgres aspect of this, and he does run some additional benchmarks and shares his benchmark scripts. The benchmark that Kaarel ran here was with an unlocked table, so we're making sure that the wall logging doesn't impact our benchmark here. We have a primary key that's a big end. We have two text columns that are not being indexed here. And then we have three, what is called here cardinality columns. These are the columns that we're querying by. And specifically, we're querying by the int 1000 and the int 100 column, respectively. They have either 1000 unique values or 100 unique values. The test data is using a generate series function and generates about 10 million rows, which results in a 13 gigabyte table. This is roughly the same size as Simon's original post. The SQL script that Kaarel pastes into Pgbench has two variables defined. For both of these variables, he gets a random value. You can use the random function in a Pgbench script to alternate which portions of the table you're looking at. And then he does the select count star from a table and looks for these two values in the table. It's the same test that Simon ran, but I think it's nice to be able to just run a script and test the different results. First, he tests an index that's on both columns, and then he tests with two separate indexes, one on each column. He runs these tests for 30 minutes each. Additionally, he notes that pgset statements could be used for reading timing information in more detail. You can use the stats reset function between runs to get the totals for all the runs. In addition to the two types of indexes that were looked at in the initial article, here we're also looking at an index that uses the include syntax. It includes syntax in Postgres. It says this column, in this case, the int 100 column, should not be used for filtering the index. It's not used to reduce the search space, but it is present in the index in the leaf pages. Once the index has found which portion of the index is the result, then it has extra data available that can be used to either return the result or do some additional filtering like is used here. The execution plan, an example, it still does an index-only scan, but instead of the column that's in the include being the index condition, that column is now in the filter. The other thing Kaarel tests here is a hash index. Hash indexes are single column indexes. So you have to create them in both columns separately. Here, this always results in a bitmap index scan of the index, then does a bitmap and then does a bitmap scan on the table. It does have to do more work because it actually has to look at the table itself. Now let's look at the results here. I think this paints a very clear picture. The composite index for querying 10 million rows takes 0.06 milliseconds. That's almost 100 times faster than using two separate B-tree indexes. It's also faster than using a covering index that includes both the columns, and it is 100 times faster than a hash index as well. Clearly, composite indexes, when you can design them right and can match your workload, they are the best choice. The structure of a B-tree means that if you have a composite index, it's able to filter much faster to the relevant portions of the index, and it can ignore everything else, thus causing less I/O to be loaded, less pages to be looked at, and it just performs much better. Kaarel points out two interesting things here. First of all, why the hash indexes didn't work better. If you look at the size of the indexes, you can see that the B-tree indexes, two separate indexes, are almost 8 times smaller than the hash index. The reason that's the case is because hash indexes don't have deduplication. This is tested in Postgres 15, and as of Postgres 13, so the versions prior, B-tree indexes have deduplication. And the deduplication really improves how small indexes are. The smaller index will load faster, will process faster, and so hash indexes are the big disadvantage there. If you had very long text columns, on the other hand, a B-tree index would have to store much more of the text column in the index itself, versus the hash index would be able to do that more efficiently. For different workloads, hash indexes could perform better. Kaarel also notes that we disregarded data modifications here. Oftentimes, in a benchmark, something will be fast, but when a query is slow in practice, if the index is bloated, for example, if you had a lot of page splits on an index, or vacuum wasn't doing its job correctly, or if your visibility map isn't updated and so index-only scans can't be used, then the numbers might look very different. It does mean that you should watch the query metrics as well on your production database, not just your benchmarks. Thank you for listening. This was 5 Minutes with Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.